Hoover Dam is one of the greatest engineering feats of the 20th century. Built during the Great Depression, it was the biggest public works project in the country. The dam provides power to three states and water to more than 20 million people. Now there's a $3 billion plan to bring the power plant into the 21st century as California and the West expand into renewable energy. Jamie Yuccas shows us how a solar and wind-powered water storage system could, in effect, turn the dam into a giant battery.
Close to a million people come each year to the Arizona-Nevada border to be awed by the mighty Hoover Dam, a 726 feet high wall of concrete housing 17 power generators.
When you look up, that is a lot of concrete.
Yep, 3.25 million cubic yards of concrete. Basically, you could pave a road from San Francisco to New York with the concrete in the dam.
Len Schilling manages the Hoover Dam, which produces enough power to support more than a million homes. The generators take in water from Lake Mead. The water is funneled through spinning turbines to create electricity. Then the water is released to flow downstream. Los Angeles is its largest customer.
55% to California, 25% to Nevada, and then 20% to Arizona customers.
The dam was built to tame the Colorado River after devastating floods. Now, the Los Angeles Department of Water and Power is looking to turn it into a giant energy storage system, similar to the job a battery performs.
In fact, it's one of the simplest technologies. Pump water uphill when there's too much energy and let it run downhill when there's not enough energy.
The LA Department of Water and Power has already implemented the plan that works on a much smaller scale here in Castaic, California.
This isn't something we're looking at lightly. This is something that has been thought about, and now it's let's look at the engineering, let's look at the feasibility.
The project calls for a wind and solar powered pump station to be built 20 miles downstream. Water would be pumped back to Lake Mead through underground pipes and sent back down during periods of higher demand. LA Mayor Eric Garcetti, a proponent of green energy, is also behind the plan.
You're talking about a price tag of $3 billion. Yep. That's a lot of money.
The cost of inaction is more. We've got drought and fires in the West. We're going to be talking about hundreds of billions, trillions of dollars of cost if we don't confront climate change now.
California has a mandate of zero carbon emissions by 2045 and stands to gain the most from the plan. While some of the businesses downriver are concerned, there may not be enough water for recreation.
So how do you sell people downriver that this is going to be a good thing, especially during a drought when water levels are low?
No, you have to listen to stakeholders that are there. We can't just do this and mandate it and say it's our dam and we're going to do whatever.
The project is in its infancy. It requires an environmental impact study, along with the debate over how the cost will be divided between all of the energy users.
The Western United States might be divided by state borders, but we really have the same electricity lines, the same water, and we realize that our fates are tied together.
A visionary project that some hope will stem the flow of climate change before it's too late. For CBS This Morning, Jamie Yuccas, Los Angeles.